Hi, my name's Jovan. I'm a student at the UTS Animalogic Academy, and today you'll be learning how to do virtual production using Unreal Engine for very, very cheap or even potentially free. Now, there are two components of this tutorial, the live camera tracking and the live motion capture. Both do require a strong and preferably isolated internet connection. These two components will be separated into a short two-part series. The first part will be using the virtual camera, and the second will be on creating free or relatively cheap motion capture live into Unreal. This video will have timestamps, so if you want to jump ahead, you can. Now, with that all out of the way, let's get started with the live camera tracking, which is free. For this, you'll need two things: a computer with Unreal Engine installed, and an iOS device with ARKit enabled. So, basically any Apple device since the original iPhone SE launch in 2016, I'll be using an iPhone X. What you're gonna wanna do is, you're gonna wanna open Unreal Engine. I'm using 4.26, which is the most recent version as of today. And you need to have the following plugins enabled. So you'll need Live Link, Virtual Camera, and Remote Session, and also make sure that ARKit is enabled. To do this, you go to the Edit tab in the top corner, press Plugins, and enable these four. Once they've been ticked, you'll see a pop-up in the bottom right corner saying to restart UE4. You'll need this for the plugins to be enabled. Next, what you need to do is to go into the project settings, also found under the Edit menu, and find the IP address section. Here, you'll need to type in your computer's IP address. To find this, open the terminal or command prompt and type in ipconfig. Your IP address will appear here. Then input this number into the section that says transport unicast endpoint and make sure that there's a :0 at the end of it, and do the same for the static endpoint section but have :666 at the end of it. Once this is finished, you'll need to restart UE4 again. Now here comes a final setup step. Go to the Place Actors panel and find the Virtual Camera 2 actor. It'll be under the Virtual Production tab. Import this camera into your scene. And that's it. You're now ready to link your mobile device into your Unreal scene. So on your iOS device, you have to install the Unreal Remote 2 app. Once done, open it up and type in your computer's IP address. Then go back to your Unreal scene on your computer, go to Window and press Live Link. Then press Source, Message Bus Source, and select your iOS device. It should come up here. The app is a little bit buggy, so occasionally it won't. So sometimes you might have to restart the app or restart UE4, but it's more of a trial and error kind of thing, but it will work eventually. And if it doesn't, potentially try using a different iOS device. Then what you're going to want to do is, you're going to want to click the plus sign next to array elements and change the drop down from saying none to transform. Now, exit from here and go into the world outliner on the far right of your screen. Select your virtual camera and then go down and select VCam. And then go to the output section and make sure that it's ticked to be active. Finally, go to the virtual camera and tick enabled. Now when you hit connect on the Unreal Remote 2 iOS app, hit play in your UE4 scene, you'll be able to control a virtual camera with your iOS device alone. Now you'll be able to control your virtual camera with your iOS device. It tracks rotation and translation, so you can walk around the scene if you want, and the camera will follow in Unreal Engine. You can also change your lens focal length and your ISO and a bunch of other camera settings inside the app. It is sometimes easy to do this with an iPad if you've got a bigger screen, because sometimes it's a little bit small pressing the buttons on here, but for now I'm using an iPhone and you can use it just fine. What you can do after this is get a shoulder rig, rig your phone to it, and then when you're in Unreal Engine, you can have proper camera moves with the shoulder rig as if you're working on a proper virtual production set. Thank you for watching this tutorial. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comment section below. If you want the free or relatively cheap motion capture tutorial without a mocap suit, that'll be available next week. Thanks for watching.